Alrighty, welcome back. As you can see, I've got the bulbs in. More on those bulbs later, with a little rubber grommets in. And I'm ready for the lenses. And of course, that's with them turned on. They are a little bit brighter than the original ones. Okay, so as I said in a previous video, the little light bulbs that came from model motor cars, I could not solder to. And the one that kind of did was definitely a cold solder joint. It did not properly wet into the leads of the bulb. The solder is just kind of stuck onto the leads. It wasn't really soldered in, so I didn't trust those joints at all. And the other one, I couldn't even get it to do that. I had those things glowing like bright orange. And, you know, I tried with the normal soldering iron, a little butane torch, and then a much larger butane torch. No matter what I did, I could not get the wires to stick. So I went on eBay, and I did a search for 1.5 volt, 3 millimeter incandescent lamps. And I got a bag of 10 from a seller in Texas. And you can kind of see their information. So this was out of Texas. I also ordered a pack of, I think, 20 from a seller in China. I have not got those yet, but these worked. I was able to solder to those perfectly fine with my soldering iron, like no issue at all. So I'm kind of thinking maybe the leads on the other one were stainless steel, and these are just normal, like what would be on a resistor or something, because these soldered on perfectly fine. And when you look at them, here's one of the ones from model motor cars. Now it's a little bit burnt, but something to mention, or something to notice. When you look at these, notice the ones I got from Texas. There's like a little tannish yellowish band here and here. I don't know if that's resin or whatever, but that's how they kind of bonded the wires into the thing here. The one from model motor cars, it was just all, it's burnt now, but it was all just one color, and it wasn't that tannish color. It wasn't like two tan bands. It was all just, I think it was more of a white color, kind of like an off-white. And when you look at the instructions on the model motor cars website on how they show you how to solder the wires to them, they looked just like this, if I remember right. I think they did. With the two little bands on it. So I think this is what they were using, and then they restocked their shelves with something else that's not solderable. But anyways, I did contact Model Motor Cars. I let them know what the issue is. I have not heard back from them yet. And just so you guys know, they had a slight fire there, so they're, you know, trying to get back on track, back to normal. So things are going to be a little delayed with them, so best wishes to them getting back to normal. And I know they've got more important things to worry about right now than me asking questions about little light bulbs. So anyways, again, best wishes to Model Motor Cars getting things sorted out there. But these are the bulbs you want. They solder fine. They look good. No issues here. But anyways, so yeah, 3 millimeter. 3 millimeter, 1.5 volt is what you want. All right, now, as far as gluing these lenses on, you know, I've been, I don't want to say stressing out, but I'm concerned about what kind of glue to use because, well, I've got it narrowed down to 4. Now, also, a previous commenter a couple of videos ago, and I don't remember who it was, but thank you for commenting. It was like 2 or 3 videos ago. I don't even remember. It was like 2 or 3 videos ago. But that commenter recommended these two products here for clear parts. This is from, is that Bob Smith Industries? I don't know. But, he recommended Bob Smith Industries. I did a search for Bob Smith Industries, but I'm not seeing Bob Smith Industries on the label here. But basically, it's the gold or the super gold plus. Well, Super Gold is thin. Super Gold Plus is thick. And this is for, well, it says odorless. It says odorless. Kind of hard to get that with the glare. But this is that's advertised as foam safe, but it's also fume free, so it does not fog clear plastic parts. And not just clear parts, but I've noticed with normal CA that not only does it fog up clear parts, but it can also fog up polished parts like chrome or paint. So this will be a really good thing to use if you're anywhere near polished surfaces or clear surfaces. Now, they do tell you that it's not as strong as normal CA, and it takes a little bit longer to set, which is fine. But they do say it's not as strong, and it's a lot more expensive. I forget exactly how much, but it's like twice the price. But to prevent fogging, I think it'll be well worth it. So definitely should be a good product. And also this one right here, Tamiya Multi-Purpose Cement Clear. I think this is relatively new, not really sure. It says for cementing clear and painted parts. So because of that comment, I ordered both of those. And so right now, my four choices for gluing the headlight lenses in is either the UV curable from Bondic, one of those two, or just canopy glue. And this is probably the weakest, I'm thinking. So what I did was I decided to test these out. So I cut some pieces of clear, and I glued them to a piece of chromed metal. And this one's the UV, this one is the gold, that one's the Tamiya, and that one is the canopy glue. And a few things that I'm checking for. I was checking for, obviously, ease of gluing. I'm checking for mess from ooze out, and I kind of purposefully left like a lot of excess, especially on the clear one, just to see how noticeable it is when it dries. And honestly, all of them look good. So I guess it just comes down to like how strong they are. So just giving a little pull test, the canopy glue already is better than I expected. The Tamiya, a little bit looser. The gold, that's nice and firm on there. And the UV is nice and firm on there. So that, once it broke loose, I mean, it's still trying to hang on, but it's off, not too hard. The Tamiya takes a little bit more effort. The CA, man, that was long there pretty good. And the UV curable, yeah. So the CA was the strongest. The Tamiya still has some sticky residue on it. So the Tamiya is still a little bit sticky. The CA was the strongest. So my thoughts are, I'm kind of leaning towards the UV. Because the nice thing about the UV is you can get it perfectly positioned. It won't set until you're ready for it to set. The CA, even though that does take longer than normal CA, you do kind of risk it starting to set and grab and hold it before you're ready for it to. But this stuff, it cleans up easily with a little bit of alcohol. If you have any ooze out, you can clean it up. If you put it on there and it's a little bit crooked, you have all the time in the world to get it rotated perfectly straight and level. And it will not set till you put the UV light on it. The main thing I was concerned about, why I was thinking about a weaker glue, was that if a light bulb burns out, if somebody wanted to replace the light bulb, they're going to have to pop this out. If you use a glue that's too strong, you'll probably damage this trying to pop it out. Whereas if you use something that's a little bit weaker, you could pop it out easier. So that was my thought process behind it. I'm probably way overthinking it. This actually held pretty nice. I'm kind of pleased with that. It held it good. It's not just going to get... And you know, I was also concerned about it, you know, during shipping or handling, it getting knocked or bumped off. I don't think it's going to get knocked or bumped off with any of these. So any of these are probably perfectly fine. I mean, it wasn't too hard breaking this one off. Again, this one was the strongest. So I would probably be fine with any of them, honestly. I just need to stop overthinking it and just glue the darn thing on, right? So anyways, I'll get that glued on. I will more than likely just use the UV stuff, just because it's easier. But anyway, so let me get that put on. I will also install the little side marker or the little side lights that go on the windshield post. I'll get those put on. And then we'll start talking about something else. Like, I don't know, maybe the license plate or something like that. So give me a minute and I'll get right back to you. Oh, and even if I don't use one of these, you know, to the guy who suggested them, these are, and for all of you out there, just from a little test I did, these are pretty good products. I'm happy with them. Even if I don't use them for the lenses, they'll still definitely get used for other stuff. So it's always nice learning about new products. So again, if any of you have suggestions for products, paint, glue, tools, whatever, you know, leave them in the comments. And if I think it's worth it, I'll try it out. But don't get upset if I don't use what you suggest. But like I said, I will definitely use these for other things, even if I don't use them for this. But anyways, as I was saying, let me get these things glued in, and we'll get back to you here in just a minute. Okay, so now that I've got those lenses in here, and I've got the headlight lenses in, finally, I went ahead and made the license plates. The license plate number is, this is what the customer wanted. I was looking at several photos that he had sent me, and as best as I can tell, there were black and white photos, but as best as I can tell, they were white with black digits and a black border. And you could see on the edge, you could see like the polished metal edge. So I just cut those shapes out of aluminum and cut them out of aluminum, filed and sanded them to shape, painted them white, masked them off, painted the black, and then sanded the edge down to see the aluminum on the edge. Now, as far as the digits go, I spent many hours searching online and at different craft stores and art stores. I was looking for stickers. The craft stores didn't have any that were the right size or the right font. I finally found a seller on eBay. I got a sheet of these. These are dry transfer rub-ons, and the digits measure 10 millimeters high, which So what I did on the black and white photo, I zoomed in until the thickness of the bumper matched, or this dimension of the bumper on the photo matched this piece from holding it onto the screen. Then I used my calipers and measured the digits, and I measured the height of the license plate. That's why they're that high, and that's why they're that size, because I matched them from the photos. And this matched perfectly, and the font matched perfecter than anything else I could find. So you just cut out the digits that you want, you put it on, you dry, you rub it on until it sticks on. It's, again, it's a dry transfer rub on. And then I sprayed it with a clear coat to lock it on. And so this is now ready to bolt to the front of the car. And this, I had to modify the tail light assembly thing. Remember, this model did not come with bumpers. On this model, the back license plate was a piece of plastic molded into those round plastic pieces here that the tail lights were then pushed through. So what I did was I cut those pieces off. I put a screw and a little spacer on there. So then that will go into the back of the car, and just put a nut on the back side. On the lights, I painted the red with Tamiya clear red. I will then just cut off that post, and I'll sand the back flat, and then that will just glue on. And I think it goes that way. And then that will just glue on right there. And then that'll be done. So I'm gonna go ahead and mount the bumpers and the tail lights. And then the next thing I guess I'll do, I'm running out, I'm getting close. The next thing I'm gonna do is the windshield wipers. So give me a minute and we'll get right back to the windshield wipers. All right, there's the rear license plate, rear bumper and lights all installed. And there is the front. So now, I want to take a look at the windshield wipers. Right, there's a windshield wiper from Model Motor Cars, and it comes with a strip of rubber. And it comes with two pieces like that. And you really only need one piece like that because you just slice off a little strip. So I only used one piece. This is a full piece. So I cut a strip off of one end and cut a strip off of the other. And then that little strip of rubber gets glued into the channel of the wiper frame there. The only thing is, right in the middle, there is a little obstruction. I think it's leftover soldering from when they assembled it. So you have to cut out a little slot in the wiper blade to clear that. Then it just presses into the, you just press it into the channel. I only glued it in on the ends, and the friction of the channel holds it in place. So the glue on the ends is only keeping it from falling out. And then there's a little, like a bezel piece that gets, it's a washer, that gets glued onto the other end. And when you buy the windshield kit, it tells you, it gives you the dimensions for drilling a hole here and here for the wiper blades. And the wiper blades just push into those holes. The thing is though, the instructions have you put this one out that way and this one over here that way. So according to the instructions, wiper blades are pointing outwards. When I look at photos online of the real car, I've seen a few where they're pointing out, but I've seen a few where they're pointing in, and I've seen a few where they're both pointing that way, and I've seen a few where they're both pointing that way. And I've seen one where this one was all the way down, but this one was all wonky, pointing up at a weird angle. So it almost seems like they just go wherever they want to go. I don't know. Because of where they tell you to put the hole is actually off-center, so they actually fit better pointing inwards. So if that one's pointing in and that one's pointing in, that's how they fit best. The post is a tight enough fit in the hole. I don't really need to glue it, so I think I'll just press them in, and then you can position them wherever you want. So I think I'm going to put them in both pointing that way, but this one's going to be sticking up just a little bit, which again, according to photos of the real thing, I think is okay. Let me see if I can get one of these in here. So that's what they look like that, which isn't completely unrealistic. Pull that one up a little bit. Now, if I move that, notice how it's hitting the frame here if I go any lower down. I can move that all the way over and it would fit perfectly fine. And I did see a photo with one like that. So I'm going to leave them like that for now. I think they look fine. The guy I'm building this for, I mean, if he wants to move them over, I mean, he could. They're a tight enough fit in there. I don't think there's any issue with not gluing them. So, I'm going to leave them like that. Now, that's going to be the end of this video because the only thing left, I just have to put the doors on. I've just left them off now to keep them safe. But I got to put the doors on. I got to put the seats in. I got to put the wheels on, and I got to do a final fit of the hood panels, and I keep putting this off for some stupid reason, I don't know why, the exhaust tips, I got to paint those and put those on, but that's easy. And then it's pretty much done. That's it, that's done. So probably the next video will be the last video, and it will be the final the final assembly, the final clean off. It's a little dusty. I got to clean it. Everything that has to go on is made. I got to put those little things in here and here. But it's just putting stuff on. The only thing I'm concerned about right now, I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. The only thing I'm concerned about right now is the hood panels. They don't like to fit. I'm a little stressed out that I'm going to have a hard time getting the hood panels to fit. But like I said, I just got to put everything together and get the hood panels to fit and it'll be done. Oh, and I just realized, I have sitting over here, I have some of these engine stickers that, well, they're not stickers. You just glue these on. They're not even water slide decals. I'm not going to use all of these, just a couple of them. One of those and one of those over there to go on the engine. But yeah, I mean, next video theoretically should be the last video. So until then, as always, thanks for watching.